Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Forma Therapy. This is the Culture Study. I'm the channel's video producer and your host. You can call me PD. And today we are checking out Athletic Girl by High Key. So, first of all, for any just confusions, I know sometimes it's a little difficult. It is pronounced High Key. The Korean spelling is Ha-E-Key. It's not H1 Key. Because I'll admit, when I saw it on paper, I was like, oh, H1 Key, interesting name. And now it's like, when I see the music video, I'm like, High Key. Oh, okay, well, that makes a lot more sense. So this is the debut of a brand new four-member girl group. That's interesting because in a world where we usually have like either five plus, you know, somewhere between seven and nine girl groups, you know, you don't get too many four-member girl groups. It's kind of rare. So that's going to be interesting to see how their formations are going to work out, what type of music they're going to be doing because of it. Athletic Girl, pretty interesting title as well. Now, they are debuting under Grand Line Group, a subsidiary of Grand Line Entertainment. Unfamiliar with either company. There's a lot of hype around the people that, like, are, I guess, involved in this company. I'm not quite too sure. Apparently, there's a CEO from Sidus Entertainment and a director from SM. But we'll see. We'll see if all those credits will back up this group's debut. Now, before we get into the video, let's actually talk about real quick our sponsors. Me, guys, if you want to support the channel, consider visiting our Patreon. We do bonus reactions over there to variety content. You know, with new groups, we do live streams where we check out their live stages and whatnot. I don't know if we're going to be doing it this month. We haven't done live streams in about 2 months, but we're probably going to bring it back in February. We've just been really busy with all sorts of other stuff, but we have plenty of other content to tide you over till then. We check out variety content, survival shows. Right now we're checking out Loud and Girls Planet and K-dramas as well. But if you don't want to support the channel monetarily, just simply like the video and subscribe. It would help us out tremendously. All right, guys, thank you for tuning in. Let's check out Athletic Girl by High Key. And this is your form of therapy. Wow, okay.
I'm athletic girl, no Peter of the ass coat. Net on a hashtag glow, I'm out shoes and she go run.
I'm already a fan of the cinematography of this music video. Oh, this is a high budget video. Color grading is already on point. Oh my! They took high budget. Ooh. Oh, this section is really interesting. That rap section was a little bit like a Middle Eastern sound. Oh, the pre-chorus is also strange. They have like this twinkling sound that gives it like this very soft feeling. Oh, damn. Wow, this scene looks super dope. Whoa. Oh my god, who produced this song? It's different. It's different. I'm a big fan of this because it's so different. The production of it, I mean, it doesn't play out like a typical K-pop song, but it also doesn't do the crazy wild thing that's the experimental style of, you know, the fourth gen style. It's not doing that either. It's just different. It's just produced differently. Oh my goodness. It was powerful, but in surprisingly a low-key way, you know, not doing like their typical, like the booming brass sounds. Like they went with just like their own thing. I think the very cool brace, the whispering sounds, I think really leans into not only making it sound badass, but also slick and just cool. And they, for a group called High Key, it's just not a song that's very as in your face as I thought it would be. I think what I also really, really liked is the visual element of the music video. The way they shot this. So I don't know how tall these girls actually are, but the way this music video is shot, the creative team did an excellent job because clearly they wanted them to look like, you know, like Olympic athletes, right? With the lenses that they shoot in, and also just even the way they shoot the dance. The way they shoot the dance, if you especially see this part right here, the way they shoot the dance, they emphasize on elongating their limbs, both their arms and their legs and their torso. So they also just seem way taller than they may actually be. I'm sure they all are on the taller side. You probably need just long limbs to be able to accentuate it in the first place, but they do it even further with how they shoot this. See how they like get right in her face and they shoot from a lower upper angle? That gives it a more powerful feeling. It makes them seem a lot more intimidating because of it. That's usually how you want to shoot stuff if you want to make someone seem really like they're towering above you. Okay, I want to talk about the song more, but before we do, let's actually just rewatch it again. I want to figure out this song structure. I'm athletic girl, no Peter off. Also, I appreciate this. I don't know how they pulled this off, this background scene. If you notice, it was all white. So it could have been just like, oh, like it's a light box that they're shooting in. And, you know, you can see that it's causing light reflecting on the walls. But then that faded in. And then you're getting, and then there's movement as you're moving closer, those things move in. There's no way that's a real infinite long tunnel. It's got to be an LCD screen or an LED screen or it's got to be an LED screen or a green screen. But if you're doing a green screen, how did they, or it might be a blue screen. Might be a blue screen because, okay, if it's a blue screen, any blue light spill over wouldn't show as much. But then how did they get the white light reflecting? Oh my goodness. I want to see like a behind the scenes for this. Wow. The way they play with the editing right there is really, really dope and well done. That's really dope. Like, they show you a bunch of different information all at once.
And the way the camera... Do you see the way the camera moved right there? The fact that the camera made such an odd movement, but based on her melody, was interesting. Oh, that was so good. It's those little things that really makes a music video pop. Okay, I really, really, really wish they... I really, really wish they had subtitles here, because yeah, I may be fluent in Korean. I cannot hear Korean. I cannot hear every single word when a song is playing. That's the same with English songs too. I don't know. Like, well, I'm deaf in one ear, so that doesn't help. But like, I'm just catching random word, and all I heard was nice feet. I'm sure it's not a weird lyric, but I'm like, context. I need context. Like, if they even had at least Korean lyrics, that's one thing. Like, this is going to be a weird critique for this company, but like, hey, you know, if you're not going to do English lyrics, which is very odd because I also read that they just partnered with Sony Music to promote overseas. They want to promote internationally. English is the universal language, that and Spanish. And so, and Chinese. So, you know, I feel like putting English feels like a given, but even just putting a Korean lyric so then I could at least translate it for people, I feel like would be really helpful. Oh, I love that part, and how they sync that together. So, I mentioned before, the undershot is a very common shot you use to portray strength and power. And the fact that the opening of the chorus is how they do that is quite incredible. The fact that the opening of the chorus is an undershot and that's how you see them for the first time, they're coming at you with this shit. They're like, nah, nah, nah. Like, oh my God. It's just, it's memorable. This girl reminds me weirdly a lot of Hyoyeon. Both visually, she looks like Hyoyeon, and she sounds like Hyoyeon. Like, her vocals remind me of Hyoyeon. And when she raps, she reminds me of Hyoyeon. I don't know, she just reminds me of Hyoyeon a lot. Like, I really like the way her huskier tone complements everybody else. But her husky tone is not just, like, the only tone she can hit. I mean, as we see later on in the song, she can also hit these crazy high notes, too. Jeez, what is this set? I just realized. Oh my goodness. There's money behind this video. What the fuck was that shot? Oh my God. Okay. They're saying, I'm athletic, girl. So the part of the choreo is them craning back their neck like this. They're emulating that through the camera. It's as if the camera was a face, the camera is also stretching back like this. Oh. This LED light tunnel is really cool. I will say, I love the use of colors in this music video. The yellow, it just pops, right? Because also, most of the members are always wearing black. So the yellow pops really, really well. The green, oh. I think I love this blonde girl. This set is so dope, but also this has nothing to do with the girls themselves, but I feel like the people who shot this music video took a very big page out of Blackpink's book. Like, there are definitely way too many similarities. I mean, it, you know, the four member, the four girl group lineup already might draw some comparisons, but I just want to say, like, it's definitely not plagiarism, but like, there is a difference between inspiration and like, okay, this is kind of like, I say this just like purely on a professional level. Like, I do feel like the music video creators, like, as much of a beautiful and pretty music video it is, on a technical side, this music video is shot really, really well. But on a creative art direction side, I'm like, yo, I've seen this music video before. This music video would actually feel very inherently unique to them if it had not been done before very specifically by another group with another very specific song. But it's dope. Man, this girl is, well, this girl is cool. This girl is cool. This girl and the girl with the purple hair, they're just cool. They're so cool. Yeah, see, she did the husky shit earlier, and now she's doing like this really high-pitched, shrill voice. Oh my God. That is a cool look. This here, the lighting, the way like the hair shines, looks super cool. Ooh, what is that? I love that. What do you guys think about that melody right there? That what is that instrument? Dun 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 dun. Oh, it's a memorable instrumental too. Ooh, it's so good. Wow, 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 wow. That's interesting. So this camera, it's so weird. Who shot this video? Because whoever shot this video did such an excellent job, especially the camera operator and the DP. This camera, like, it feels so playful and alive. Like, this camera is like, all right, I'm gonna go dip like this. And then she starts dipping. So then the camera is like, to create a much more dynamic image, yeah, they could have moved with her, like waited for her part where she's going down like this for the camera to move down with her. But instead, they're moving the way she's gonna go. But then when she starts going, they go the opposite way. And it creates just like this much more cooler visual image. Ooh, the purple and yellow Lakers represent. Oh, I'm sorry, wait a minute. This music video has been blowing away too much that I have not paid attention to this song structure at all. All right, hold on. Wait. So, 256. Is this the second chorus? First chorus. Second part. Second chorus, okay. All right, second verse, rap. Oh, I love this buildup. Okay. Okay. So for the second chorus, so if we imagine the let's call that the whisper chorus, and then let's call it the louder chorus where they go, "I'm athletic girl." Excuse me in my broken voice, but so in that first chorus they do the whisper and then the louder chorus. In the second one, they just straight up go into the louder chorus. And also, hold on, I need to confirm something. They also add something in the second chorus that I thought was in every chorus. No, it only starts in the second chorus. It's like this. It's like a crying type of thing. Like here. This. Whoa, they went higher. They were, that "I'm athletic girl" was already high. And then they went higher. Oh my God. So every chorus is different. Every chorus is different. There's slight differences, but oh my goodness. Wow. So then bridge. Back to the quiet whisper. Oh, I love match cuts, baby. That was not a fly. That was a feather. I don't know why there's a feather in here. But this match cut. Oh, oh, that is slick. It reminds me of Youngji, the rapper. Oh, okay. So then they do the, for the third chorus, they do the quieter whisper one, and then they skip the "I'm athletic girl" and they just straight go to the high one. I love this part especially because it feels like when they hit that high note, it feels something like they're raising the stakes. I don't know. It feels like the tension is higher and it's got me amped up. Oh, wow. Wow, 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 wow. Wow, wow. Ten out of ten. That was an incredible debut. I mean, for me, it's like up there with Bugaboo. Like, Bugaboo was one of my favorite debuts last year, and Athletic Girl is up there as well. It's quite incredible how good this song is and how much charisma these girls have. I'm kind of digging the vibe. You know, I think Blackpink really did get the formula right in the sense that, like, hey, how about having a smaller group, but everyone is just really, really good? It changes the tone rather than having like a 10-member group and then like four people get like all the lines and then like the other six are like doing little stuff here and there and trading off. Like, I, you know, that's not to say there's no place for big member girl groups. I mean, after all, my favorite groups are IZ*ONE and 17, but at the same time, I really like these smaller groups debuting and it feels a little bit more like a combat unit debuting. Like, they debut and it just feels like, oh my God, I got slapped in the face. Oh my goodness. Athletic Girl by High Key, 10 out of 10. I do feel like, again, the music video was really, really dope and it's very visually appealing. And ultimately, I think some people are going to disagree with me, but I do think that the palette of the direction of the art of this music video is largely a little too lifted from Blackpink. And so that's not a problem. It's just like, okay, but like you know, they've clearly got the production quality and they've got the visual aesthetic and they've got the budget. I would like to see a music video that is like, I guess, more creative and original to them rather than it feeling inspired by something else. There's nothing wrong with that, but, you know, especially for a debut, I really like when a group makes a statement. Now, they did make a statement with the song and the moves and everything, and ultimately, really, it's only like slightly inspired. It's not like heavily inspired. There are various enough scenes, what is this scene we see right here? Like, what is she singing? Like, she's singing from an apartment building, you know, on Mars, right? You know, there's enough weird, like, solo scenes. Like, you've got this girl just stretching constantly. So there's enough unique scenes that, I wasn't showing you guys. This one, this girl just stretching. And then her, she's got an apartment on Mars. There's enough unique scenes that I would say, you know, it's definitely not a problem, but I do want to see a little bit more, I guess, uniqueness in the future. But my God, they are so impressive. And I'm like, what we saw with Bugaboo and now with Haikyuu, I can't confirm. Let me look it up real quick. Okay, this is very interesting. So something I noted about Bugaboo, it's like they skewed on the older scale, kind of debuting idols in their early to mid-20s, which I liked. So with Haikyuu, they definitely present themselves as kind of much more mature idols. And the person here with the purple hair is the oldest. Born in 96, which would make them 26 this year. I don't know. I'm bad at math. But the average age seems to be like 20 for the group. She is 20. She's 21 or 22. Something like that. She's 20, 21, something like that. I'm still doing 2021 math, so I'm also a little confused. And then the other girl, she's actually the Magne, which is weird. And also, she's only like 17, which is weird because I thought like maybe she was the oldest. So I don't know. But I really like the idea of like debuting much more mature concept idols, as long as definitely it doesn't feel like exploitation. And while, you know, I do want more mature idols debuting, mature styles debuting as well. I think especially if you go back to like K-pop and like that Stellar era and the way like the exploitation there was like way too like, it felt weird, you know, and it felt definitely just not right. And, you know, Athletic Girl, I think, chose that line. And so I want to pass that question off to you guys. I personally think that like, this music video, it did not feel exploitive. It felt perfectly appropriate. But I'd love to know your thoughts. You know, that's just a worry I tend to have when you debut a much more sexier concept. And that's definitely what they're going for here. But I do think it towed that line really well. But guys, thanks for tuning in to my reaction and review to Haikyuu's Athletic Girl. What'd you guys think? I mean, that's a 10 out of 10 for me. It was fantastic, but let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. Guys, if you would like to support the channel, if you enjoy what we do, consider visiting our Patreon. We do listening parties over there. We also check out variety content, survival shows, and K-drama. So if you want to check that out with us, it's over on our Patreon. Of course, you don't have to support us monetarily. You can just like the video, check out our other videos over here, and be sure to subscribe over here. And we'll see you guys next time. Bye.